What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Locked Up 365. Today, I'm going to be talking about the intake process, all the way from booking to the drunk tank to the assessment pod before you get to the dorm, basically. Real quick, if you're new to my channel and you haven't subscribed, go ahead and do that now so you can be notified as soon as a video touches down. All right, the first thing you got to remember in me telling you all this, each jail is a little bit different. Like, I've seen some, like when you pull in the Sallyport, they got a little room for the CO to take all your belongings, search you, make sure you don't have contraband on you. Some jails don't have that. They'll take you straight into the booking area where you got the glass with the guards on the other side, and they will take all your property. They'll make you take the stuff off, put it in the bag yourself. So each jail is a little bit different, but we're going to go. Soon as you pull into the Sallyport, you're going to see a big steel door. That's the door you're going to be going in and you won't ever come out of, unless you're going to court. Now, when you go in that little room, there'll be a CO, because they have to pop a door on their side. They'll come in, your door will pop, you'll go in with the cop, the CO will strip you down of everything, like your wallet, your keys, things like that, watch, necklace, your personal belongings. They'll take your shoes, so you'll just have your clothes on. Once they do that, then they'll pop the door, you'll go in, and if there is a wait, you'll have to sit down in these uncomfortable plastic chairs. Some jails do have a TV for you to sit there and watch, but some don't, because most of the time they don't want inmates just hanging around sitting in their booking area, unless they're backed up. But if you go in there and there's nobody in there, you're going to get straight in. They'll set you down at another hard, big plastic chair, and there'll be a booking officer. They'll want to know your name, date of birth, your eye color, your weight. They want to know everything about you, if you have any health issues. Now, if you have any kind of health issues, they're going to call the nurse. Or if you're like an addict, if you tell them that you're an addict or an alcoholic, they're going to call the nurse. The nurse is going to have to come check your blood pressure and all that. And if you're on medication, that is the time to tell them you're on medication. Because if you don't, then a few days later, you're like, hey, I need my medication. It's going to be a harder process to get your medication because you didn't tell them when you got booked in that you took medication. All right, so once you get done with the booking lady, you'll go over and take your photo. Each jail is set up different. Some of them actually have, it's just like a webcam that they use, and they'll snap a quick picture of you. Sometimes they have, the actual camera will be on the ceiling. It'll look like something you see at Walmart or Kmart for security, you know, like one of them little bubbles. And they'll just take it, zoom in and take it that way. Every jail that I've been in, the fingerprint and mugshot is side by side. Like, it's literally connected. Usually they'll use the webcam off of the fingerprint machine to take your photo. But when they do your fingerprints, they got to do each digit. And then they got to do your whole palm, fingers and all. And then they do just your palm in case of a robbery, something down the road, and they only got like a partial palm print. They want that. All right, so once you get into the drunk tank, we're just going to say that you're going to at least be sitting for 30 days, okay? So usually the next morning you'll have to get up, go to court, and the judge issues you 30 days. You will go back to the drunk tank, and they will start assessing you as a risk level. Now, when you came in, if you said you were suicidal, you're going straight to the hole immediately. You won't go to a drunk tank. You'll go to the hole and they'll put you in a turtle suit. Now, a turtle suit, they take all your clothes. You're butt naked, and it's literally just this green. It looks like a flap jacket, or if you ever had an x-ray, them real heavy things that they put on you, it's like that. There's a front and a back, and there's straps that come around the side. The straps that are up top and on the side, they're wore out so much from so many people using them. They don't ever stay strapped, so they're always falling off. I couldn't tell you how many times I've seen those things fall off trying for somebody just to get their tray. But if you're not suicidal and you've seen the judge, he's giving you a 30-day sentence. Usually it's like a 2 or 3 day process for you to get assessed. So yes, you will be in an uncomfortable concrete room with probably 10 other people stuffed in there, toilet out in the open. So if you got to use the bathroom, you got to do it in front of everybody. And I'm not going to lie, usually the drunk tank smells like a dirty sock. Like, it's awful. I've literally seen people come into the drunk tank and they smelled so bad, they had to take the other inmates out, because a lot of people, you know, whether they're homeless or if they're just on a lot of drugs and they're not taking care of themselves, they're not changing their clothes, you know, their feet just stink. So it smells like a dirty sock at all times. It don't matter how much they would clean that room out, it's just in there. So definitely be prepared when you go into the drunk tank, it's going to smell like a dirty sock. You could be in there up to 14 days. Usually they get you out 2 to 3 days, and they'll get you to an assessment pod. Now, an assessment pod is where they take you just to clear out the drunk tank. And it looks like a little 10-man dorm. Sometimes there are like 20 people in there. Just depends on what the jail has, really. But they all have an assessment pod that they take people to. Now, once you're in the assessment pod, you can't get commissary or anything like that. But you could wait in there for up to 2 weeks also. So it just depends on how packed the jail is, like I said. If the jail's not that packed, you might go from the drunk tank. You could be in there a day and they put you straight into a dorm. But if the jail's overpopulated like crazy, then you're going to sit in the drunk tank for a while. Then you're going to sit in the assessment pod for a while before you get to an actual dorm. All right, so once you leave that drunk tank to go to the assessment pod, that's where they'll strip your clothes, your actual street clothes, and they'll put you in black and white or orange and white, whatever color they have. I've seen green and white, but they'll put you in an actual uniform, give you flip-flops if the jail does give you flip-flops, because I've been at some where they don't give you flip-flops. They just make you rock out with your bare feet or socks. Most jails, if you have like a white t-shirt on, they'll let you keep that. If you have white underwear, white socks, they'll let you keep anything white. Anything colored, most jails take that. I have been at jails where they will let you keep any boxers and any socks. It don't matter what color they are, they'll let you just keep those two items. But you can't order whites. You can't order t-shirts. You can't order thermals, anything like that. The only thing, period, you're allowed to have is boxers and socks. Now, once you get to the assessment pod, what you're waiting on is for them to assess your risk level. If it's first time ever being in there, you're going to a dorm. But they're trying to figure out what dorm to put you in. So when you're in the assessment pod, they're basically assessing your risk level. They're trying to place you somewhere that you won't cause problems. So if you have a history of violence in the jail, they might put you in the hole. Or they might put you in like a disciplined dorm. If you're 25 to 40, you go in a dorm. If you're 40 to 80, you go into a dorm. You know, they try to split people up so there's less problems. Because if you get 18-year-olds in with 50, 60-year-olds, more than likely that young buck is going to cause problems. Or they just don't want an 18-year-old beating up on an old man over a ramen noodle. I don't know how they really figure out where to place people, but that is what you're waiting on. You're waiting on that assessment. Once you get done with the assessment pod, that's when they will take you. They'll take everybody out at once, and they'll drop you off at your dorm, and you'll go in, get your rack, stuff like that. And they will bring the next batch of people that's been waiting in the drunk tank, and they'll put them in the assessment pod. It's a never-ending revolving door in the county jail. All right, that's all I have on this topic. If you haven't subscribed, go ahead and hit the subscribe button now. If you want to follow me on Instagram, Facebook, or become a member of my Patreon, I'm going to leave a link in the description below. If you would like to check out Locked Up 365 merchandise, I'm going to leave that in the link below also under Teespring. Thanks for watching Locked Up 365.